My company, Christie Machine Company in Fremont, Ohio, has been a member of NFIB since the 60s. My ex-partner Lamar Christie is the one who started Christie Machine Company in 53, the year I was born, and joined it with NFIB in the 60s. And I took over in the 70s. I've got a young man now that's buying my company the same way I bought it, sweat equity. Didn't have a dime to come into it. But anyway, I'm concerning his future and where he's going with his company, and just where we're at in general, based on employees, people.
Yeah.
People. And I guess one of my questions is, and I know what this gentleman here from IGA spoke of it takes a village. Well, he didn't finish it. It's an African proverb. It takes a village to raise a child. I'm a born-again Christian, and I'll tell you what, Proverbs 22:6 says, train up a child in the way that he should go, and he will remain when he's old.
Yep.
I want good employees.
Yeah.
I don't want employees that go into theaters and shoot up people. Mm-hmm. I don't want employees that walk into buildings with bombs. I want good employees. I need children structured so when they're adults and of working age to come into my plant and be good employees. So my question for you is there anybody in this government, is there anybody bold enough to take a stand and reinstate prayer in our public schools where we have our children as a captive audience with a divorce rate at over 62% in this country and single parents concerned about everything going on other than the real welfare of their children? And how they're going to be sculpted. But I'm looking for somebody in government to advocate. Has it ever been put on the table and brought up for discussion? I've heard nothing about it. I heard it in the churches they talk about. I understand that.
Well, look, one other issue that's big is in light of the Supreme Court decision on marriage, we're very concerned about your religious liberties. So
Christianity is not religion.
No, I understand. But the...
So way of life.
Congressman Labrador, a good friend of mine, a colleague of mine from Idaho, has the First Amendment Defense Act, which would protect churches and folks. Remember what the First Amendment says about, it doesn't say freedom of religion, it says freedom to free exercise of your religion. You have the in America, the ability to practice your faith.
Free of love, not from.
Yeah, so that's an important piece of legislation we need to get passed.
Absolutely.
I don't think the president will sign it. What we can do in education is encourage choice. The court has spoken. I think it's wrong. I think we should be able to pledge to the flag and pray in schools and all those things that have historically been a part of our culture and a part of our country. But what we can do is give parents the choice to send their son or daughter to the school they think they're going to get the best education and the type of values that are consistent with their beliefs. That is good. Competition
is
good.
Training. This is a training issue.
Yeah. And so in places where you have school choice, you find all the schools improve, education quality improves, and some of those core values are better as well. So that's what we can focus on. That's largely, you don't want me doing that. I mean, I can talk about it, but you want the state and locales to and local communities to be handling the education. You don't want one of the questions last night that they asked, and it should be a state and local issue.
Well, some of our teachers today are having sex with their students. You know the issue is going on everywhere. Not everybody is a safe individual, and I understand that. But every school has an auditorium, and every class can be taken out of the auditorium the first half hour of class to pray with elders coming from the different churches, not one church dominating.
Yeah.
It could be done. If people just put their thinking caps on and put their hearts into it and consider a way, it could
certainly
be done.
Bring
the elders of the church and pray with the kids. Teach them how to pray.
Yeah.
Don't tell them who their God is, but teach them how to pray.
The current concerns in our culture are real, and it seems like you have a Supreme Court, and in some cases, leadership who aren't willing to remember the values that made our country special in the first place.